Good morning, students. We are going to start the new topic, dielectric constant of a material. The symbol what we are using is K. Let us start with the last topic of the last video, that was reduced value of electric field. In determination of reduced value of electric field, we had seen the electric field in between the two charge sheets having charge densities plus sigma and minus sigma. Then the electric field we had there as E naught is equal to sigma by epsilon naught, when here the vacuum is the medium. Now we, in the second case, in between these two sheets we placed one dielectric, and the polarized value of electric field was Ep sigma p wall divided by epsilon naught. That was there, where sigma p is polarized surface charge densities on the surface of dielectric that we had. And the reduced value of electric field we had also determined. This is actually plus to minus Ep. And E naught has the direction from plus to minus in that case. Here also the same. So reduced value of electric field denoted by E inside the dielectric is difference of the two, and that was sigma minus sigma p divided by epsilon naught. These three things we are going to use here as well, just to determine some more things. So we are going to start part of it. We know for a linear dielectric we have sigma p is proportional to, here sigma p is the polarized surface charge density, you know, and E naught is the applied electric field. So as and when E naught increases, in the same way sigma p is also generated. So if sigma p is proportional to E naught, it's quite obvious. From here we can write sigma p is also proportional to sigma, because E naught is proportional to sigma. So from these two, mathematically we can also write sigma minus sigma p is proportional to sigma. On removal of proportionality sign, you are going to put a constant 1 by k. Here, this equation, here k is a constant, it is called for a given dielectric known as, or it is k constant characteristics of dielectric or the medium, you can say. So this is the thing. If you are going to use this sigma by here, from here one more thing you can find out. K is equal to sigma by sigma minus sigma p. What you can predict from here, this sigma minus sigma p is quite obviously less than this. So K value is greater than, that is what you are getting. Let this be equation number 4, using 4 in 3. So if you use 4 in 3, you have E is equal to sigma divided by epsilon naught k. Here epsilon naught k is called permittivity of the medium. And that is also, you know, epsilon. It is simply epsilon. So the same equation can be reduced to E is equal to sigma by epsilon, or the same thing what you had written, epsilon naught k. This is, say, equation number, this has 5 and this one has 6. You can write. From here, this epsilon naught k is equal to this much. Take this as 6, this one as 7, that would be better. From 7, if k is unity, or for you can write vacuum, K is equal to 1. Then the equation 6 gives epsilon equal to epsilon naught. Equation 6 gives epsilon equal to epsilon naught. What is epsilon naught here? This is permittivity of vacuum. You have read this in Coulomb's law in electrostatics, the same thing. And we are going to find out the value of K in terms of electric field. If we are going to divide equation 1 by equation 7, so equation 1 divided by equation 7 gives E naught divided by E is equal to E naught is what? Sigma by epsilon naught. So this is sigma by epsilon naught. E is sigma by epsilon naught K. Sigma by epsilon naught will be cancelled out. So E naught by E you are getting K. So this is what you have. K is equal to E naught by E, or from here you can say E is equal to E naught divided by K. So this is the relation you are getting. So finally you are having two relations for K. First relation you are getting here, K is equal to, this is equal to sigma divided by sigma minus sigma p, and also K is equal to E naught divided by E. So this is the, these are two relations you have. It is not clear, so I'm going to overwrite this. K is equal to sigma divided by sigma minus sigma p, and from here K is equal to E naught divided by E. So finally the relation of dielectric in both the cases, what you see, numerator is greater than denominator. Here reduced value of electric field, which quite obvious less than E naught. From here you can see. So in both the cases what you are going to get, that K is always greater than 1. Here it is, you can say this K as electric field in vacuum to the reduced value of electric field in dielectric. This K is sometimes also known as a specific inductive capacity. Sometimes it is also named like this, SIC. This is another name of dielectric constant K. So we have to find two relations here, this and this. This and this one. In general, it has not come even once, but this relation is frequently used in numericals and everywhere. But at least you should know how we are going to determine. So this is applied value of electric field vacuum between a two plates having surface charge in the sigma and minus sigma. This is polarized electric field in a dielectric in the terms of surface charge density or polarized surface charge density of dielectric. This is reduced value of electric field that we had determined in the last class. For linear dielectric, polarized surface charge density is directly proportional to applied field, and thus from here sigma p is also proportional to sigma. So mathematically the difference of two will also be proportional to that. To remove the proportionality sign, you are putting a constant K. That constant is called the constant characteristic of the given dielectric. From here, K you can find out, this is, it is here. If you substitute the value of K, sigma minus sigma pi P from here to this value, this equation, what you have is this relation, E equal to sigma by epsilon naught K. This you have one more. And here this particular quantity epsilon naught K is called permittivity of the medium. So epsilon, and that is also denoted by epsilon. So this is epsilon is called permittivity of the medium. So if you are going to substitute for epsilon naught K as epsilon, the same relation you are getting in both the form. if we are going to put K is unity, this is for vacuum, K is 1, so epsilon equal to epsilon naught, call permittivity of vacuum. If you divide equation 1 by equation, this one, 7, you have, so E naught by E you are getting from here, and that is what K. So K, you determine the ratio of applied electric field in vacuum to the reduced value of electric field in dielectric. And thus, we have the relation of K. The conclusion of dielectric constant or specific inductive capacity, whatsoever we have seen. First, we got this epsilon naught K equal to epsilon. That was the, from here only K we got epsilon by epsilon naught we can get. So this can be K, the dielectric constant can be defined as ratio of permittivity of medium to the permittivity of free space or vacuum. Here this is defined as permittivity of the medium, and this is also the single symbol for this. Second, we had sigma minus sigma p is equal to sigma by k. So from here also we are getting k as sigma by sigma minus sigma p. This can also be defined, but there is no such need, but I have written it. Ratio of surface charge density of the sheets providing the applied field to the difference in surface charge densities. You can mention surface here, surface charge densities of sheet and the side of dielectric, the two sides of dielectric. Third, we had K is equal to E naught by E. That was the last conclusion what we had seen, E naught by E. So from here we are getting E naught applied field, i.e. the reduced value of field inside dielectric, that can also be written like this. So this is the ratio of applied electric field intensity, this one, to the reduced value of field, both are same, of electric field inside the dielectric. Here what we see, in all the cases, the denominator is less than the numerator, here, here and here. So in that case, generally for this case, dielectric K is greater than 1, that we have. Second, as far as unity is concerned, in all the three cases, similar quantities are written numerator as well as denominator. So ratio will be dimensionless and unitless. So K is unitless, it has no unit, as well as it is dimensionless. So this is the thing. First is K greater than 1. It is unitless, and as well it is also defined as dimensionless. You had also determined the same thing in Coulomb's law in electrostatics. At the place of K, it was epsilon r, the relative permittivity of the medium. So that is almost having the same way of explanation. Next is relation between surface charge density sigma, which is on the sheet, and induced surface charge density sigma p, that is the polarized surface charge density on the two sides of the dielectric. So here once again we are going to see the two things the same. Here you are going to give plus sigma and minus sigma. In vacuum, the electric field you have, that you have E naught is equal to sigma by epsilon naught 1. Again the same thing, you are going to place the dielectric here, plus sigma, minus sigma, here minus sigma p, plus sigma p. The polarized electric field, its direction is just opposite to the applied. That polarized electric field Ep is equal to sigma p divided by epsilon naught, equation 2. Now the reduced value of electric field, you also know what is reduced value of electric field. You know the reduced value of electric field is the reduction in the applied field due to the opposition called polarized electric field. So we had the relation from last video that reduced value of electric field in dielectric, reduced value of electric field in dielectric is E is equal to E naught minus Ep. You know this E is equal to E naught by K from the dielectric constant. You have this idea. The last topic what we had just seen. This E equal to E naught and minus EP. Put the values. Here E naught is sigma y epsilon naught K equal to. Here also E naught is sigma by epsilon naught minus what is EP? Sigma P by epsilon naught. Cancel out epsilon naught from both the sides. So you are left with sigma by K is equal to sigma minus sigma P. This gives sigma P from here. Sigma P is equal to sigma minus sigma by K. Take sigma common. You shall have 1 minus 1 by k. So this is what you have, the value of polarized surface charge density in terms of surface charge density on plate and dielectric constant k. So this is the relation what we are needed. Now we would like to see some of the special cases, and the cases are somewhat like this, the special cases. First case for dielectric, you know K is greater than 1. In the just in the last topic we had seen in the determination of dielectric constant value, K greater than 1. If K is greater than 1, then this is less than 1. So whenever this 1 minus something, that will be less than 1. If you multiply with sigma, this relation gives simply. So equation you can name anyone. Suppose this one is 3 and this has 4. So here equation 4, equation 4 gives, O gives, you have sigma P is less than sigma. It's quite obvious sigma P will be polarized value of surface charge density less than the applied one. Second case, for any metal or conductor, in between the two applied field, two surface charge sheets, you are filling a metal. What will happen? There are two ways to find out sigma P. Either you write, you know inside the metal, the polarization or distribution of charge as such, the net electric field inside is zero. So you can say the net electric field inside or reduced value of electric field is zero. Or you can, other way, you can use dielectric constant for metal is infinity. In both the ways, if you are using K equal to infinity, sigma P is sigma. And if you are going to use E equal to 0, then this equation also gives when E is 0, E naught equal to EP. So either from here you are getting E naught equal to EP. And from here you are getting this is sigma P equal to sigma. From here you are getting sigma P equal to sigma. And from here also, if you are putting the value of E naught and EP, you shall have it is sigma by epsilon naught and this is sigma P by epsilon naught. On cancelling epsilon naught from both the sides, you shall have sigma P equal to sigma. So in both the ways, you are able to find out the same thing what you are getting here. In both the ways, both the places, both, sorry, either K equal to infinity or E equal to 0, you are getting the same result. Third case, for vacuum, K is unity. In the last derivation of dielectric constant, we had used this. K equal to 1. If K equal to 1, this is 1 minus 1, 0. So sigma P is equal to 0. So there is no such polarization of the in the vacuum, because there is no present availability of any molecule or any material to be polarized over there. So finally, we have the relation of polarized surface charge density to the surface charge density in a plate with dielectric constant, and thus the derivation here. Here one more extension can be seen. If you are multiplying this with area of cross section or dielectrics like this, suppose you are using plate here and dielectric is somewhat like this of this. In between the plates you are using. So this is the area of the plate and this is the area of dielectric. If these two are common in on both the sides, then what you can say, if you are multiplying this area here, sigma, which is sigma P into A, that is charge, polarized charge is equal to this sigma into a, both sides we are multiplying with A area. This is Q and this is 1 minus 1 by K. So even the induced charge can be seen or determined with the help of this particular relation. So one more, besides this relation, we are getting induced charge, polarized charge on the dielectric here. At this place, sigma P was there on right side. So this is QP on this side. So this is minus QP and here minus sigma P. So this is what you have. Small, if small Q is used, you write a small Q. This is what. We are going to see the relation between polarization vector P and induced surface charge density sigma P on the surfaces of dielectric. So we have to see the dielectric first. Let us try to see a dielectric in between the two sheets of charges plus sigma and minus sigma. The dielectric is this. It has minus sigma P and plus sigma P. This side is negatively charged, this side is positively charged. The polarization vector P, we know it is in this direction. We have idea of this, we have read it. Now if you see the dielectric in 3D view, it is somewhat like this. So this is the one face, second face, these two are parallel to the plates of the sheets of the charges sigma, plus sigma and minus sigma. Let on this we had given plus sigma P, surface charge density, on this minus sigma P. On this is charges, induced charge are plus QP, say small QP we are taking, then take small QP, and on this is minus small QP. The area of the plate, this area is A, and this distance between the two parallel sheets of charge of dielectric is D. So there are some parameters you have to mention in derivation, like let A, area of the dielectric facing the plate, that cross section, D, distance between two sheets of charges plus sigma P and minus sigma P. So V, volume of the dielectric, that is equal to A into D. You have this equation 1. If QP is the charge on this, minus QP on this, so this is behaving like a dipole, we had studied this. So D is distance, so induced dipole moment of the dielectric, that is say P net, magnitude is QP into D. We also know the surface relation between surface charge density and induced charge, A with area. So sigma P is equal to QP by A. So QP is equal to sigma P into A into D. Here you can mention using sigma P is equal to QP divided by A, that you know it. This A into D is volume, so you can write net dipole moment is sigma P into V, where V is the volume. This is equation number 2. What is V? V is the volume used from 1. Now the polarization vector. You have the idea of polarization vector. Polarization vector. This is P. The magnitude is net dipole P vector is equal to net induced dipole moment divided by volume. You have read it once. The magnitude also the same in the same way. So P is equal to P net. P net the magnitude is sigma P into V divided by volume V. So from here P is equal to sigma P. What you had to prove. So that is what we have proved it. Sigma P is also QP by A. So that can also be written in terms of charge. P equal to polarized surface charge of the dielectric per unit area. That can also be seen in this way. This vector can be written in terms of the direction of area. Suppose in this direction, the outward normal is this. And on left side, the outward normal is this. So this sigma P from here can also be written as P dot N. How it is so? On right face, what you see, the polarization vector, it is rightward, P is rightward. So on right face, what you have? Right face of the dielectric. Angle between P and N is equal to 0 degree. You see, P is rightward, N is rightward. So if these two are 0 degree, then this sigma P is equal to mod of A into mod of B in 1 into cos 0 degree. So that is sigma P is P, that is positive, what you are getting. So that is why sigma P is positive on the right face. On left face, if you see, left face, what you have, angle between P vector and N vector is equal to 180 degree. Just see, here it is rightward, it is leftward, so angle is 180 degree. So 180 is here P dot N, so sigma P is given to P into 1 into cos 180 degree, that is minus 1. So from here, sigma P is going to be negative. And that is why the left suit is having negative charge. This also be the way to see the surface charges over there. If the polarization vector and N vector are not parallel, or P vector is one direction, area vector, area process is one direction, then that can be seen like this. Sigma P is equal to mod of P into mod of N into cos of the angle between P and N, cos theta. So this is, in this case, suppose P vector in this direction and N vector in this direction and angle is theta. In that case, you can. So this sigma P is equal to P cos theta. This is the case. What we have to see in this. Dielectric strength of a dielectric or any material. We have studied that when a dielectric is placed in an external electric field, it gets polarized and atoms and molecules are stressed. So the internal strain is generated. With an enhancement in applied field, there will be increment in the stretching as well as the strain so produced. When the applied field is high enough, there may be knocking out of electron from the molecules of the dielectric. And the dielectric starts conducting. And this phenomenon is said to be breaking down of dielectric. This avalanche of electron thus produced may cause spark in the surrounding medium. The dielectric strength of a dielectric is defined as the maximum applied electric field that a dielectric can withstand without breaking down its insulating property. So the definition is written here. It is the maximum applied electric field E naught that a dielectric medium can withstand without breaking down of its insulating property. So here, if EBD is the breakdown electric field or the potential gradient, this can also be potential gradient, then this can be written as applied potential difference for breakdown per unit length or width of a dielectric. So let this be D, if this is the distance D. If you go for SI unit of dielectric strength, what you get is volt, and this length is meter. So this is volt per meter. Some practical unit may be considered in higher value, but SI unit will be this. If you are going for the dimension formula, it is either from here you can write electric field force per unit charge, or by this, this is potential difference work done per unit charge into distance, and that's equal to ML2 T minus 2 divided by AT, and distance is L. So this gives ML is this T minus 3 from this, and here A, this is A minus 1. And for the values for some of the standard, the like EBD for some of the materials like say air, that is frequently we are going to explain about this. This is around 3 into 10 to the power 6 volt per meter. Or you can say for our air range of length 1 meter, the applied potential difference required is 3 into 10 to the power 6 volt to break down its insulating property or to allow the charges to flow through it or conduct. For vacuum, this is infinity. So it's very large, so this cannot be achieved, so it's not possible to polarize the region. You know there is no such presence of the medium in vacuum. For safe zone of dielectric or safe limit of dielectric, what you can say, the same value of applied electric field should be less than, it's quite always less than, I'm writing less than equal to 10% of the breakdown electric field or this breakdown strength. So just for safe limit or to keep the dielectric useful enough, the limit should be less than the breakdown value of electric field.